We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. And if, which I do not for a moment believe, this island or a large part of it were subjugated and starving, then our empire beyond the seas, armed and guarded by the British fleet, would carry on the struggle until, in God's good time, the new world, with all its power and might, steps forth to the rescue and the liberation of the old.
This is LCT 7074. She is the last surviving Mark III landing craft tank. When I say last surviving, she is the last surviving LCT that took part in the Normandy landings. She was taken up finally to finish up in Liverpool, where she was a floating nightclub. She was left to basically float in the dock, and eventually the rainwater coming into the tank deck here was enough to actually sink her. The NMRN then raised money from the National Lottery Memorial Fund, and they gained around £1 million to do that. We were privileged to be part of that, to salvage LCT. We were fortunate enough to have space within the on the naval base in Portsmouth here. Once she was in the ship hall, we were able to take a good look at her and work up a National Lottery Heritage Fund application, which was successful. What we did to bring this 200 tonnes of LCT onto the beach and then onto the road was that we constructed a pad on the beach at exactly the right level, so that at the spring tide a barge could be floated in with LCT on it to butt up against the quayside, and then once the tide goes out, the barge would settle onto our billiard table of a beach, and then we would be able to build bridges and track the LCT off on special tractor unit. That was supposed to happen last Thursday, and we got winded off, and we tried again on I believe it was Saturday night. What we learnt, and it was a pretty hairy experience out there, because the wind was on the cusp, you know, whether we went or we didn't go, but because of we were running out of tides, we thought we'd give it a go. The large tugs actually turned the vessel around, and then the small tugs were trying to get in, and of course they were on the windward side of the LCT. It had become very rough and very difficult to get lines onto the barge, so the pilot quite rightly called the landing off, and which was a great disappointment, but it was perfectly understandable. The barge went away. We, the main contractor, myself and a couple of others, had a bit of a council meeting to try and work out, right, okay, we've got to do something different. If we can't bring it in on this high tide, it's going to cost at least £250,000 to remobilise everything to do it in September. So there was a lot of pressure on to try and make it happen, but of course we had to make it happen safely. In talking to the pilot, they came up with a new way of connecting up the small tugs. The beaching was within 300 millimetres of our ideal spot, which I think is pretty good. We had a slight list on the beach. Then came quite a slow process of putting the new bridges in between the barge and the quayside, and actually tracking the SBMTs off the barge. And then once she came onto the road, it was lovely to hear all the locals who were watching this operation give the driver a round of applause, because he'd done really well. So that was a great moment, actually. And I always said, once she's on the road, I'm happy. It was a matter of a drive down the road to arrive here at the LCT canopy. And then today, a couple of days later, you can see behind me maybe the Churchill tank has been loaded on. And we've got one more tank to go on, but at the moment we're too windy to be able to do that operation at the moment. So Mother Nature has thrown everything it can at us, but she did give us a nice window to bring the barge in.
So Artelia have been with us all through this incredible journey for the last 6 years, since 2014 when we salvaged the ship from the bottom of Birkenhead Docks. Their project management has been extraordinary in an incredibly complex operation, not just conserving and restoring a ship, which we've done together many times, but in this case actually moving it twice, once from Liverpool to Portsmouth and then once round by sea from Portsmouth to here in Southsea. So the attention to detail and the ability of Steve Prowse in particular, working with Steve on this, has been an absolute pleasure. We've enjoyed every moment, although there's been some really challenging times.
Artelia project managed the project from start to finish, so we've been responsible for sourcing and managing the contractor who've restored the vessel, ML UK. And Artelia also have the design team sitting below them who've designed the canopy and dry dock. I hope that lots of people visit and take the chance to stand on the tank deck, look out over the ramp and get a feeling of what it felt like to land on Gold Beach on D-Day all those years ago.